Here at Brake Parts, we manufacture rotors. We want to sell your rotor, but we also realize that sometimes you have to machine that rotor. Now, we don't make brake lace, but we do want you to do a good job. If you do have to machine that rotor, we want you to have that brake job that everybody's happy. So I want to show you a couple tips here with this brake lathe, what you want to check. Now, the first thing I'm going to start out with is the arbor itself. Now, if I just turn this machine on and look at the arbor, it looks fine to me. But here's what you really have to do. We're going to install a dial indicator and check the runout of this arbor. What they call for is 1/1000ths or less. Now you're probably thinking, wow, that's pretty tight tolerance. But don't forget, almost everything that you put, every rotor that you put on a vehicle nowadays calls for 2/1000ths runout or less on the vehicle. So think about this. If I've got 4 or 5 thousandths runout on the arbor, every brake rotor that I machine will have that 4, 5, or 6 thousandths runout on the rotor. Then when we put it on the vehicle, you might magnify it by having a little bit of runout on the hub itself. So what your goal is to have that rotor with 1/1000ths or less runout when you install it on the vehicle. So we're gonna go ahead and put a dial indicator on this arbor and see what we have on this brake lathe here. So we installed the dial indicator and we put it on the arbor. You don't have to put it way out in the end. Most of your rotors are gonna be mounted right around in the middle or actually even closer, but we're gonna check it right about in the middle. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn the machine on now. Wow, as you can see, we really have an issue here. We've got about, probably about 18 thousandths run out on this arbor. Remember, we're supposed to have 1/1000ths or less. We've got a real issue here. Either somebody dropped a large drum or something, but we're gonna take this arbor off. It's pretty easy to actually take this arbor off. There's a nut on the other end of the brake lathe. We take that big nut loose and this arbor will come right out. We're gonna inspect it, see maybe there might be some metal shavings built up in this area right here. Maybe we have a bad arbor, we have to replace it, but we always first take it out, check it, and clean it, put it back in, and see if we can't get this back where it should be. In this case, when I pulled the arbor out, I could see a lot of metal shavings that actually got in between the arbor and the bearing assembly right here. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna take some sandpaper, light sandpaper, clean this all off, clean off the inside here also, mate this back together, and this time, we're gonna line up the little witness marks. This is the original arbor, and the reason I know that is it has our little mark right there on the arbor. We're gonna make sure that mark lines up with the mark actually on the brake lathe itself, and that is the way they built this brake lathe to get the lowest amount of runout. So we're gonna line those back up, clean everything off, and we'll recheck it again. So I'm gonna go ahead and just start cleaning this right now. A real good trick for cleaning the actual brake lathe is to turn the machine on and just hold the sandpaper in there. We've cleaned the arbor and the brake lathe. We reinstalled the arbor. We lined up the original witness marks where they aligned it when they built the machine. I reinstalled my dial indicator. Now we're going to turn it on and see if we still have that same amount of runout. As you can see, now we're down to right around 1,000 runout, which is what the maximum allowable on this machine. So we still fall within that. Now here's the problem that sometimes we forget about. Just because we have the arbor perfectly 1,000ths run out, sometimes we forget that we have to use the cones, the adapters, to hold that rotor in place, and that's just as important as the actual arbor itself. So the next thing we're going to do is show you how to check the actual adapters and cones and make sure they're in good shape also.